Don't be afraid, only believe. You know, we've been in our week of prayer and want to thank God for Pastor Bill Markham.
Thanks, Bill.
Over at Central Community Church, and just a wonderful brother of another mother and joining us here. Yeah. You know, Lori, as we've been talking, really there's a lot of issues that are going on in the nation right now that people are concerned about. Yeah. But one of the things that I believe that is a linchpin is the church. Yeah. Because as the church goes, so goes the nation.
Yeah. Yeah, I believe God's doing a new thing in our country, in our church. And as we're all been pastors, or you guys are still, you know, pastoring, and I speak outside of the church.
And you
all
are
that
as well.
Good
yeah.
stuff.
Yeah.
I am. Yeah. But the thing is, you can get kind of stuck in your, let's admit, as pastors, we get stuck in our ministries.
Yes.
And we lose sight of things. And it's really, I just feel God bubbling up and stirring up grassroots movements across our country, you know, in regards to the church itself. The church is looking different across our country than it ever did before. What do you think, Bill?
Yeah, well, I think it has to.
Yeah.
I think sometimes innovation is born out of desperation.
Right. Mm.
And I think if you are aware and open your eyes, it doesn't take a lot to see that the church is in decline on the surface.
Right. On the surface.
Right.
But I think that there is a real hunger for presence. I think there's a real hunger for something more. And I think most Canadians are actually searching and actually open to the truth. And so I think that's where it's going to come, when we can begin to address those real legitimate needs that most people have by being present.
Yeah.
You know, I really believe you're right. I think that we're now beginning to recalibrate our thinking, especially as
a
church,
to.
Right?
And we
do have to. Every business does this, everything does this, right?
Yeah.
But what you said, Bill, I think it really strikes a chord as well, because as we're now looking at the complexities of the issues that we're dealing with, I believe what God says, before I have an open door for my church, I need an open mind.
Yes.
And I believe that that open mind also is going to translate into open wells. Because, you know, the Bible said something very interesting. It says in Genesis chapter 26 and in verse 18, it says, "And Isaac dug again the wells of water which he had dug in the days of Abraham that had been stopped up, but he named them by the same names." Mm. And I feel like there are wells of revival in the nation, and I believe that God has raised that. But we need not only our minds to be open of what the Spirit of God is doing right now, but we need to open those wells up. I mean, 1921, Central started, and God did some great work there.
Well, I think, and Jesus said it this way, you need a new wineskin.
Yeah.
So the wine is good. Mm-hmm. It just can't be put in an old wineskin.
Right.
And what he meant by that is that God's Spirit is the same.
Yeah.
Yesterday, today, forever.
Yeah.
God's desire and passion for people is the same.
Yeah.
Those things never change. God never changes.
Mm-hmm.
Sometimes we're wondering.
It's a good thing.
Exactly.
It's a good thing.
Well,
right?
it's like the earth orbiting the sun. We got to rotate to the sun to feel it. And
yes.
So we got to move toward God. So I think people just need to help realigning their life around this reality that you were created in the image of God.
Yeah.
God loves you. Love's the only thing that's going to change the world. Jesus is the best example of what that looks like, so follow him.
And I think that's the key. What, you know, no prayer, no power, some prayer, some power, much prayer, much power. And we've got, thank you for sending in your request. And could you lead us in that as we're praying for the church and just with the prayer requests that we have that people have been sending in? You know, because I'm hearing a lot about salvation and unsaved friends, and I know that's on the heart of people, but I really believe it starts with the church.
It does. And, you know, like all these prayer requests, we you know, they've been all prayed through and will be prayed through again. But we see all these individual needs, and I appreciated what you said just earlier that, you know, maybe we need to ask God to change our hearts, not so much the situation.
Yeah.
And that's so true even in our churches. Like we can get our heads down and think, oh man, the church is, you know, struggling. But actually, it's like change our hearts.
Help us to see
what you see, God, in our nation. We should never be afraid to ask God, what do you see in Canada, right?
I agree. And
100%.
I think, too, I've changed the way I pray.
Yeah.
I used to pray for God to change the situation. Right. God, change this or change that. And actually, I've changed to say, change me.
Yeah.
Because I know if God changes me,
it
will change the situation.
It will change the situation.
100%.
Yeah.
And so, you know, as I'm looking at these prayer requests, my hope is that we would begin to say, God, show me what you want to do in me.
Yeah.
Why am I in this situation? And
we
talked about this earlier. Yeah. The great heroes of faith, if they didn't go through their situation, they wouldn't be overcomers.
That's right.
They wouldn't be in the Bible.
That's right.
So I want to just let you know that you were designed to be an overcomer. So be an overcomer.
Amen. Yeah. Come on, lead us in that prayer.
Yeah. So, God, thank you so much for who you are. Thank you that you never change.
Amen.
We can be certain in a world of uncertainty, in a world filled with fear, we can be certain, God, of your character, your nature, your desire, your mission, your love for us. And so, God, I'm praying for every one of these needs that have been presented. God, I know that we'd love for you to change the situation, but sometimes you want to change us in the situation.
Amen.
And so, God, I pray for those who need healing, that they would, again, understand exactly what you're doing and saying to them in this moment in time. Yes. For those especially who have, they've identified family members and loved ones that they want to see come to mm-hmm. faith, I pray that they would understand that they are the chosen mechanism that you want to use to bring love into Amen. Those situations. Mm-hmm. And so, God, I just ask in Jesus' name that you change us.
Amen.
You change us, and in so doing, God, change our nation.
Yes, yes, and I agree with that. Father, I ask you to give us your eyes to see, your heart to see yes. people, that you would change the heart of our church, because you're going to change the leaders and those in the church, that we would get our eyes off ourselves and stop actually feeling sorry for ourselves. I just actually break that off in Jesus' name, that we need to be overcomers in this day in Canada, that you are at work in Canada. We believe and we want to ride the wave of your goodness and your love. And I pray that it would pour out of the churches, that those of us who lead, those of us who love the church, those that gather in the church would go out with the love of Christ every space, everywhere
in
they
Jesus
live.
Name.
We'd overwhelm this country with your love, Lord, and you will and are doing a good thing, and we praise you in Jesus' name.
And Father, unplug the wells in our heart first and in the nation. God, would you please flood this nation, Lord, that there would be hearts that would be broken. There would be wet eyes, broken hearts, and bent knees once again at the altar. There would be water on the altar. Lord, let tears now begin to flow in this nation. And Lord, we pray that you'd bend the church to save the nation. Bring us to that place that we would be a sending nation once again, because the nations are here. So let us see them and be that church of this generation. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen. Well, Matthew 5:68 says, blessed are those who hunger and thirst for righteousness, for they will be filled.
Blessed are the merciful, for they will be shown mercy. Blessed are the pure in heart, for they will see God.
Ask God to open your eyes. Thanks for watching.